Okay, hi Acro and Cheer Girls. Today we are working on our drills for headstands. So I'm just gonna tie my hair up and then we're gonna get started. We're not gonna do a warm-up to start. You can do that by yourselves with one of the other videos. Let's just jump straight right in and focus on our headstands. Okay, okay. So first things first, I'm gonna do it on the carpet because I don't have a mat at home. I've left them all in the buildings where we teach. So if you don't have any carpeted floor, maybe try it on the grass outside, or if you have a mat then use that. First things first, I'm going to go sideways so you can see me. For the start of our headstand drills, we're going to do our upside down triangles, okay? So what you need to do is make sure that your hands go right beside your knees, okay? There's not to be too far forward or behind your knees, right beside your knees, and then your head is going to go down to make a triangle. So your head goes further away, but it's to make a triangle in line with your hands. Okay, so if you can picture that, that's great. Pop your head down. Okay, now you've got your shape of your triangle with your hands into your head. You're gonna tuck your toes under and try to straighten your legs. Just to here. Okay, so that's the first step. That's our upside down triangle. You're trying to lengthen your back, making sure your back's nice and straight and not in a curvy shape. So have a few practices. Make sure as well that your head isn't too far away to give you a down, like quite a flat triangle. Get mum or dad or brother and sister to check that you're not in a flat triangle. You're in a nice spiked shape with bum right up in the sky. Okay? Let's practice that quite a few times. Off we go. Again. And once more. Nice straight legs, bum right up into the sky. Good. Okay, to make sure that you're in the right shape for that, I would suggest trying to set up if you have an iPad or mum or dad's phone and taking a video so you can see if you look the same as me. Okay, because if you're trying to move on to the next step and you've not got your correct triangle shape, you're just going to fall. Okay, so the next part of your step, once you're up in triangle, you're going to take one leg in beside your tummy, not away up here, in beside your tummy, and down, and then the other one. Okay, that's just strengthening the position that we're in, making sure you've got the balance. So have another practice of that. Triangle. Good job. And again. Perfect. Okay, moving on from that. If you're managing to spring your legs in quite easily and pop them down without wobbling around, it's now time for you to try and lift 2 feet. Now, if you're not so comfortable doing 2 feet straight away, what I advise is going against a wall. So I'll do it over here so you can see. I'm coming quite a bit away from the wall. My hands are still beside my knees and I'm going to put my head right against the wall, okay? Make sure you can feel it. There we go. You're going to push up. One knee up and then the other knee up. And you can push against the wall, making sure that your feet are only in that top shape, okay? Practice it a couple times against the wall. Okay, notice that my hands are back from the wall. They're not right up here beside the wall, they're back beside my knees. Okay, you can practice that for a good chunk, that'd be great. Okay, now, once you've mastered it against the wall, you can try it in the middle of your room. And when you go up, we're really working on not pushing our backs out of line to make us wobble. They've got to be in a nice poker straight line. So, hands, head, straight legs, one leg in, the other leg in, and squeeze. Hold it there. Good job. Okay, perfect. Keep practicing that. making sure it's really nice and stable, you're not wobbling around, and be extra careful that you're not going to flip all the way over. You should always come back down the way that you've went up, okay? If you flip over, you're going to damage muscles in your neck, you're going to hurt your back, so just try and go feet back down to the floor the way you came. Okay, so another practice. Good job. Okay, perfect. So I'm going to set you a bit of a challenge. I want you to see how long you can hold your tucked headstand. If mum or dad are around, they can video it and send it to me so I can see. And we'll see who can hold it the longest. Miss Bethany can hold it for quite a while, so I won't count myself. But let's have a practice. See how long you can hold this one for. And I want to keep practicing throughout the week and send me how long you can hold it for. So time yourselves, okay? Hold it for as long as you can. Good job. Squeeze all your muscles. Good job. If you held it for the same time as me without coming down, you're probably ready for our next step. So my invitation only acro class is working on this, and a few of Lauren's older cheer girls could probably try this. So once you're up in handstand, up in your upside down triangle, we can try and develop it into a straight headstand. So watching from side on, just watch this time. You're going to go from triangle, you straighten your legs back into your upside down triangle, but this time you don't bend them in. With your straight legs, you want to try and keep them straight and lift them all the way up, like a clock. The clock hands don't bend, okay? So you don't bend your knees. From here, up, you're going to do a little bend and push all the way up. Squeeze, 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 and hold. Okay? So, I want you to be extra cautious that you're not bending your knees in if you're trying to go up to straight legs. You should be going from tucked, pinning your legs up, that'll throw you off and knock you down. If you're wanting to try the straight leg one, if you're feeling a bit more confident, you bring them from low all the way ticking up to high. I'll show you one more time. So from here, they stay straight all the way up and hold. Okay, so I had a few in my invitation only class who were getting this, so I'd really like them to practice it. I'm going to show you now what I don't want to see, okay? So this is something that you shouldn't be doing when you're practicing your headstands. You shouldn't be going from tuck shape, straight legs, because that'll make you wobble, okay? You should be going from tuck, back down, and if you want, straighten all the way up. Ooh, a bit faster, okay? So practice those headstands. Send me in how long you can hold your tucked one for. Invitation only girls, you can send me how long you're doing your straight leg one for. Okay? Can't wait to hear how you're all doing.